5 or 6 maybe. Kira is not with us today, unfortunately. She'll be back on the next week. But we are here, myself and Trainzy, playing Douglas and Daelon, back in this terrible, terribly cold world in which we're inhabiting at the moment. So I guess we should meet who we are, who we're playing, that sort of stuff. So I'll start. Why not? I am playing Douglas Templeton today, the human fighter, who since last last week he took a massive nerf thanks to a donation from Touchpad TV. He previously had 21 strength. He now has 11, and all of his stats are nerfed, basically. So thanks for that one, Touchpad. But he is a very angry human fighter. His alignment is angry. He's got his short cropped hair, and a big long sword over his back. And he has no soul, basically. Absolutely no soul at this point. And thanks to Squeegee for the host. How's it going, man? And training. So, that is who I'm playing today, Douglas Templeton. And he's got zero soul, and so he doesn't really know what he's doing at this point, Avalon, trying to find a soul by killing people. Last time he cut off someone's head and tried to find their soul within the stump. So turns out it wasn't there. So hopefully he'll have better luck this time. Who knows? So Trainzy, how you doing, man?
Doing well. Yeah, I'll be playing Daelon Oakbringer today. Oakbrewer, my bad.
He brings a brew.
Yeah, he's a stocky dwarf. He now has a very full beard, but similar kind of shabby clothing aside from a very fluffy jacket. He also experienced enhanced clumsiness. He was already a clumsy dwarf besides that. But yeah, ultra bro-y, lovable dwarf if you like getting cursed and enjoy awkward situations.
I do. I certainly do. So, Brian, do you want to remind us what we're doing in today's story?
Yeah, so you guys, if you recall correctly, and I hope you do, the last time we were here, you had just arrived in the town of Waldsby, which was well, let me backtrack a little bit. We opened on a combat because you had just arrived through the winter portal that was causing this unnatural winter in the middle of summer in your, I want to say homeland, but it wasn't really homeland. It was near where you were from. You went in, you killed the troll at the portal. You took on the oath to carry on the Dark Rider's task to find and free Baba Yaga, the mother of winter. And you had learned that Baba Yaga had been trapped or kidnapped. So you went through the portal after taking this oath, and as soon as you came in on the other side, you were transported somewhere else, somewhere new. And as you went through the portal, you found a group of people who were in the middle of fighting a giant mantis, praying mantis. You helped them out, and in exchange, they offered you shelter in their camp, which you accepted. You were joined in their camp by a very strange, female fey creature. She had sort of horns and like those kind of dog leg, not really dog legs, deer legs, we'll say. And she seemed to be a little bit weird, but still, but you know, but still personable. And yeah, pretty weird though. None of that really mattered because Daylon decided that he could not take the loss of his cart, and he flew into a rage and attacked. There was a fight a little bit. Kira attempted to break things up, and eventually the woman managed to flee into the woods. You guys, very confused and very shaken from the night, bedded down. You went to bed, and in the morning you were taken by this troop of people to this town of Waldsby. Waldsby, which in layout and in structure seems very familiar to the town that you originally left, called Heldrin. Inside Waldsby, you met Nadia's family, and along the way you learned about her missing daughter, Thora. And everything seemed all right. You were going around town, you were meeting people. There was some strange magic things that happened to all of you, and Daylon did in fact manage to buy his, what he thinks is his cart. It might be, it it seems like his cart, off of a kind of shifty young child who said it was his.
Stole it from an orphan.
You bought it from him for 200 gold. And everything seemed to be going fairly well up until the soldiers from the Pale Tower came into town and began
looking. This is when the barrels became important.
Yeah, they came looking door to door for you don't know what, but they were looking for something. And what they found was you guys as you ambushed them outside of Nadia's house.
Yes, we ambushed them, we cut off their heads, we blew them up, and I stayed in a barrel for the most part.
Yeah.
Because I was hiding.
You killed a couple of the guards, and you learned that the leader of the guards was apparently taking prisoners in, I think you have the RPG lab for Hosen. The leader of the guards was taking prisoners from the town in the tavern, which you guys could not stand. You originally set up a plan where you were going to roll a barrel into the tavern. That didn't go so well, so what you did was you kicked open the door, and using Daelon's Molotov cocktails, you set the place on fire. And while it was on fire, you proceeded to slaughter pretty much all of the guards except one, including the leader. But just as the leader of the guards fell and the building is on fire and the citizens are cowering, the mirror that was at the back of the bar sort of frosted over and covered with ice, and in it you saw the image of a stern, angry woman with shock white hair and a frozen crown on her head, as she said that she knows that you have taken up the mantle of the Dark Rider, and that she knows that you are seeking Baba Yaga, and she will not let that happen. And so with a wave of her hand, the mirror image vanished, and a flurry of cold flew into the bar and formed a knight dripping with icicles and clad in heavy armor. And as he leveled his sword to you, he made a declaration. And that is where we are going to pick things up, because you guys are still in combat. So let me see if on roll 20 I have initiative. I don't know if I did. I did. Okay. No, wait.
Today is Touchpad's birthday. Happy birthday, dude.
What's going on, man?
Happy birthday, girl, man. Despite the fact that you are the bringer of pain and all things terrible. Appreciate it, dude. Can't be also. There you go, then. Leave all the way. Also, I remind you guys of a few ways you can interact with our show throughout today. Of course, if you haven't tweeted, check out this tweet here. 25 retweets, you guys get to decide what happens in our game. It's a lot of fun. Last viewer session we had, it vetoed all of Cold Harbor's Season 2 and said it was all just a dream and Josh is left screaming. It was a lot of fun. So if you want more crazy stuff like that, then just get to retweeting. Of course, if you haven't followed, hit that follow button and join us. We're something like 35 followers away from you guys having a second viewer decision. So that sounds good, redundant. That sounds good. Good luck with that audition, buddy. So other than that, you can, of course, donate to affect this game. I can play as Nat 1s, Nat 20s, revamp all of their stats if you're feeling evil like Touchpad was last week. And Wild Magic Surges, Wild Magic Items, Bounce, all sorts of stuff. So that is the ways you can interact with our show. So I'll hand over to Brian for our combat today. Happy 31st birthday, Touchpad. Still looking good. Still looking good.
Alright, I'm just...
Brian is muted. Drink.
Yeah, I'm just hitting you up with a retweet. No, okay. So why don't we go ahead and dive right into it, because combat did sort of end. So why don't we throw some new initiatives in?
Let's do it.
And let us
minus two initiative.
Yes.
For those guys who weren't here last week or who don't remember, my phone is I don't know why it's doing it. That's weird. I will just keep my face close to it. I will do the thing which changes that. Hopefully that will fix it. But for those of you who weren't here last week, basically Touchpad donated to make us all re-roll our stats, but they were re-rolling our stats for 3d6 and not 4d6, so it was pretty bad for us. Most of our stuff went okay-ish, but mostly pretty bad.
Yeah, well, you're crazy quiet.
Every morning it does it, and it seems to just level out, so I don't know, honestly. I don't know.
Maybe the mic just needs to.
It just needs a bit of warm, bit of TLC, I think.
It needs to get used to you. All right, let me find my thing. Okay, so I got you guys in. You should be able to enter your own initiatives. You should be able to type them in, and let's get this nice stat block.
My initiative is free. Okay. I'm minus two to initiative now. It feels bad, man.
Yeah, why doesn't it have initiative on these? I don't know why.
What was Mike's just like a strength now? Yeah, that's what I was. I just went to do red. It doesn't seem to be doing that. I've got it ticked off, so.
Okay, so. He has a 7. Not really that good. And Nidair has donated $3 saying, Cat Torturer! Cat Torturer! Nat 1 for the Cat Torturer.
Thanks, Nidair. I appreciate that. That is me. I will.
I was actually, by the way, I was just listening to that last night. I was just listening to you skinning that cat alive.
Why? Just as.
I was just rewatching the episodes because I wanted to. Yeah. It's my. Hey, it's my thing. Don't judge. Alright, so, Daelon, you got your initiative rolled?
I could just roll a d20 because zero initiative alone.
Yeah. Alright, and let me see if Catherine has an initiative here. Nope, she has an initiative of zero.
What's up, bud?
So, you guys are not doing very good today.
That's salty, it's okay. Happy birthday, Touchpad,
though. Ryan, Touchpad, we like it.
It was Touchpad who donated for that, right?
Yeah.
Well.
Nidair gave me the nat one.
No, I meant the stats.
Oh yeah, that was tough.
Yeah.
Oh, I gotta give me a second. I gotta I'm having issues here. Let me just check my API settings. Okay, so while you're doing that, whoa. Okay, I got a crazy output error. Let's reboot that and hopefully get everything sorted. Okay. Daelon, you are up first as we jump into our first round. Across the burning inn from you, there is a table and there is part of the floor on fire, and the fire has been spreading, so it's, you know, it's not covering the entire bar right now because you've only been in combat for maybe a minute, but it is spreading. And there is, right across from you, there is a knight covered in frost-covered armor.
Okay.
Daelon doesn't look too good right now. Oh, it's been weird. Oh, wait, no, wait. Daelon, take his soul.
Is he, like, engaged, ready to act, or?
He leveled his, you remember, he leveled his sword at you and issued his challenge in the form of a knee.
I'm just gonna awkwardly kneel. Just look up at him. Like really wide eyes.
Okay.
That's it.
Alright. Catherine is going to go, and I guess on her turn, let me see if she put him in here. She did!
Does he respond at all, or is it just as like,
he does not respond.
Get fucked.
Okay. Now she has some interesting spells here. Okay, so on her turn, she is going to, let me just check something, because I don't know the spells here.
Sure.
I gotta reference these.
Sure. Yeah, Kira does, just use touchpads, Kira doesn't look just really dark today, she's a normal self.
Yeah. Okay, so she's gonna say, I got this! And she's gonna start conjuring a cloud, and just sort of between where Daelon is kneeling and the knight, she's actually gonna create a cloud, she's gonna conjure this 20-foot sort of sphere of yellowish-greenish gas that is going to engulf the knight. It does not engulf you, Daelon. It's just sort of like just stopping a foot or so, like 5 feet or so away from you. But she's going to conjure that on her turn, and it is going to engulf the night.
Her voice has gone really deep for me. It's so weird. Yeah. She's using a voice
control. Yeah. She talks like this now. Hi, I'm Catherine. Okay. So, as she does that, she says, I don't know how long this will hold him. And it is going to be his turn, and on his turn, he has to make a constitution saving throw. So, saving throw. And he will make his constitution saving throw.
Damn it, Kira. You were battling this last week.
She says, well, as she's walking through, she says, try and keep him in the cloud! As he is going, you see his form just sort of emerge from the gas at you, Daelon, as he is going to lift his sword, his, like, frost-covered sword with two hands, and swing it at you. Remember, by the way, did you apply your level up?
Did we level up?
No, he did.
No, I
leveled
up. No, I haven't yet.
Okay, you should go ahead and do that.
Yeah, so, you have an opportunity now, I think. Oh, he's raising it at me.
Well, he's gonna swing. I was just asking if you were to play.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
Well, I'm still
easy. Headed,
he's free.
Alright. So, good luck.
Everything
hits me, don't worry.
16's gonna hit you?
Oh, for sure.
Alright. You are, as he brings this sword down out of the cloud, you get, it kind of carves across your chest, and you're gonna take 8 damage. Alright. We are moving on. Douglas, it is your turn.
You look really epic because I'm kneeling anyway, so just slash me. I'm just like,
Yeah.
Spread my arms out.
Did I make a character friendly? Yeah, I did not. Okay.
Okay, I'm gonna move towards this guy, and I'm gonna say, do you have a soul? And I'm gonna swing with my sword straight at him with my crappy attacks. 13.
13 does not hit him, it just carves across his armor.
It would have done 2 damage. It would have done 2 damage. I am the worst.
Give me 1 second.
Fight us against some, like, inert penguins.
Yeah. Bring your souls.
We can grind and level up.
Yeah, we gotta go slightly easy areas and start grinding to get these levels up again. To get my strength score back.
Yeah,
get some
yeah.
Slimes.
Yeah. Get some dire rats and some kobolds.
Okay, I am. Give me 1 second. I'm just making a character for Nadia. And thank you, Storm, the DK snub.
What's up, Storm? Good to see you, man. Storm's been doing some awesome fan art recently. I've seen it on the Discord and on the Twitter. It's awesome.
Really, really legit. I wish I got fan art.
Maybe you will.
Maybe one day. I'm just making a sheet for.
By the way, has my mic been better? I think
it is now. Yeah.
Yeah, I think I found. I think it was Skype which was taking exclusive control of my mic.
Alright, let me just.
Grind those bears. We gotta get those bear pelts and those wolf pelts. Bring 10 back to the quest giver. Sounds about right. So,
Okay. So, on her turn, Nadia is going to. I forgot to put her in, but she's gonna. I'm gonna put her in last. She is going to rush in and sort of have her bow drawn, and she's going to fire it at the knight, trying to kind of keep him on the back foot. So. That is a 22 from her, is definitely going to hit as it finds a mark. You see an arrow just sink into like the chainmail part between the plates of his frozen armor as she says, I'm gonna try and get the people out of the tavern.
I just forgot that Nadia is like, she's like a mother of three young kids, and she just like shagged the dude in the neck, and now she's fighting this badass boss. What a girl.
She fights for survival. She's a tough woman. She is a ranger, by the way. She has levels in ranger. Okay, so as we go back to the top of the round, Sir Fiverr is going to donate $5 and say, chat chooses a player to roll wild magic.
Oh, damn. That's a new one. Thanks so much to Fiverr. Very generous, my friend. Let me give you that gold. Thanks, Redundant Flat Hosts. Oh, everything's happening at this point. So I guess the first person in chat to wanna
throw out a name. Tell me who in the fight, and I'll say it could be anyone. It could be the knight. It could be any of the players. Astrin. not even the, just me. I get a wild magic surge.
There you go.
I don't know if it works that way. Redundant says Trainzy. Give the magic roll to Astrin. Daelon needs some magic in his life. I see some Daelon love.
I see some Daelon love. Or is it love, really, when you want
it to... It is. It could be. I don't know. Give it to Daelon.
Looks like a lot of Daelon.
Yeah, Daelon. It looks like... All right, we're going to wait for one more vote.
Thanks, guys. Feels great.
You guys let us know.
Daelon, you need like wild like magic.
I think, yeah, I think chat has consensusized that it is going to be Daelon. Who's going to get that love?
Oh yeah, another vote in for Daelon. Here we go.
Give it to Daylon's cart.
Oh, that would be
lovely. All right, so Daelon, go ahead and roll me that D10,000.
Oh, God.
Here we go. For those of you who don't know, this is our D10K table of madness. We're actually looking to update this table. We have a new one, which we might change it to. It's actually even more insane than the current one. So.
Is it? Oh man, I gotta see that.
Probably bring that in for.
No, it's low.
Oh, it's low.
Ooh, that's not always good.
No, it's never, it doesn't matter what number it is, it's never good.
1520.
Let me find it right now. 1520. Daelon. What? I have to look this up. Hold on, before,
when the DM doesn't even know what's going
I'm,
on.
No, I legit have to look up what this is.
Oh dear.
Alright, oh, it's a thing. It is. Okay. Daelon, you are affected. Oh, okay. Interesting. Interesting. So Daelon, you kind of feel I guess your aura, the aura around you was always one of apathy, I guess, and thus probably neutrality.
See.
But you, that isn't really the case right now, because your aura sort of scrambles, meaning anyone who looks at you, or anyone who tries to identify your alignment, or whether you're lying or not, will be misled.
Oh.
You are affected by the spell called Nahal's Nonsensical Nullifier. Basically, when someone tries to detect your alignment, you get a random roll to see what they detect.
Huh. That's interesting.
I mean, he was already such a person to not understand anyways.
So they, like, hide your alignment, kind of, yeah.
Yeah, except you don't know what... It might show you as chaotic evil. Nice. It might show you as good. You don't know.
Yeah, it's like a completely...
Unless they're, like... Yeah, it could be bad if they're, like... religious, and they're like, oh, you're a Satanist, or what's, I didn't roll it.
They just, it's like, you're a paladin, they detect alignment, they just see, like, a kill, like, a murderer, a yeah. baby killer.
It's not just like Kira when you get that voice, that's weird.
Alright, so, that is going on, and it is back to your turn.
Oh, mine, after I took the sword in my chest. I'm going to just hop up and spear that knight in the chest.
All right, go for it.
Do it. Ooh.
A 19 will hit.
Ooh. I'm gonna attack again. Attack twice, you know, because things.
Oh, you get a second attack, don't you?
Well, yeah, level 5 extra attack.
Yeah.
All right, first one.
I'll let you just use the. You don't have to roll it again. I'll let you use the second one, because you already made two. I wouldn't screw with you like that. That's not fair. You jab this guy. Tell me how you jab this guy twice with your spear.
So, So he dashes me across the chest,
mm-hmm.
and then I just jump up, leap to my feet, and go with like a downward stab into the towards the neck, trying to find the creak in the armor, and then I'm gonna use a key point to actually double punch.
All right, and as that's going on, Survivor is gonna throw another five into the pot. Says sorry for the further interruption, but Douglas needs. I'm assuming that said wild magic. I missed it before it finished.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it was some wild magic. Thanks so much, Survivor. I appreciate that, my friend. Give me that gold, buddy.
And, we appreciate the interruption. So as you're rolling your D10,000, you go ahead and roll me twice the damage on that. And did you want to throw your flurry in with it?
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
There we go. 6, 3, 10. Basically. 63, 10.
All right.
Ooh.
So that's 11 damage on the spear strikes.
Nice.
And all right, so a total of 16 damage. So as you jump up, you skewer downwards, and you just kind of cut up with the spear. And then as the spear's coming, you kind of like land an elbow and a fist, and you're knocking this guy back. He is going to take a whole bunch of damage from that as he is staggered backwards. And as that is happening, what do we got? 6, 3, 10.
Yeah, that's right.
I'm scrolling down to it.
Let's see.
6310 is going to be the target. Thinks he recently murdered someone and is on the run. What else is new?
That is perfect.
So, he's stabbing him. Douglas, you realize that you just murdered a shitload of guards.
I did.
They're coming for you.
They are.
You can't go back to prison.
I really can't argue this.
Oh, not prison.
Oh no, I won't have any soul in prison. I'm convinced I'm on the run at this point. I am.
Yeah, you need to get out of this situation.
Yeah. Perfect. Thanks again, Survivor.
All right, so he is the knight is gonna take a whole bunch of damage. Let me just make a note of that.
I think I've murdered a cat recently, and I need to run away from his cat brethren.
And then that was 16.
I'm gonna be haunted by Tybalt's like friend. I think.
That's oh my god. Cool. You're like sleeping, and they're like.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Cool. So as we go on to that, The knight will sort of stagger back a step, and Catherine, again, let me bust open her sheet. She is going to, she's gonna just throw an Eldritch Blast at the knight.
Do your magic thing!
Well, I like that. I like this. She has all her spells actually put into her character sheet, so I don't have to do anything.
There you go.
I just punch things.
Oh, yeah. I just clicked. That's the way I like to play.
Alright, so the Eldritch Blast is going to shoot two beams. The first one does not hit, but the second one is going to strike for a little bit of damage, a little bit of the 8 damage right there. Alright, that is going to be... Yeah, okay, cool. I got it. So as the beam strikes him, he is going to stagger back the final step, and he is back within the realm of the cloud. So on his turn, he is going to have to make another saving throw, which he fails. And as he kind of is, the cloud engulfs him again. You hear just a, and he is. As he fails his saving throw against the poison, he is basically going to spend his action just coughing, and you hear him like hacking up, almost ready to vomit, as he is within the stinking cloud. Alright, so he really can't do a whole lot of anything right now. He is thoroughly disabled in that stinking cloud. Douglas, what do you want to do?
I wanna smack him.
Okay. Commit more murder. Go for it.
Commit more murders and more murders. So I actually have two attacks on me.
Yes, you do. Nat 1, you are going to sort of stumble yourself into the cloud, nice. But you can sort of swing wildly with the second attack, as you just managed to clip him in the back. Go ahead and roll me some damage on the second attack.
Okay, that's right, Douglas only ever killed bad guys at this point. 7.
Alright.
There we go. Some damage. I just wish I had some strength in my bones.
All right.
He's like the oldest man at this point.
As you smash your sword into his back, you hear, you feel kind of his armor breaking under it, and the ice, you hear the ice shattering off of it and falling to the floor. And as we go to the top of the round, Daelon, what do you want to do? You want
to... Oh, I'm going ham sandwich.
All right. Fix him some lunch.
Yeah, I'm going to... attack again. Not satisfied. Will not be underpowered. You would not look at me like this.
Go ahead and throw me those attacks.
15, or 21 and 15.
The 21 will actually... No, Doug, this isn't behind him. The 21 will hit, yeah. Go ahead and throw me some damage on that.
Alright. Oops. Then I'll just do one arm. Then the attack. So 6.
Alright. 6. That brings it to
0. Right?
How do you want to finish this guy?
Hey, called it.
So he's in. I have to enter the cloud.
No, he's just on the edge of it. Like, he's just within it. You can strike in with your spear without walking into it.
Okay, so I want to, like, stab my spear into his side and go up, like, kind of, like, edging off his armor. I'm going to, like, pop off the cuirass. I'm just going to punch him right in the heart.
So, like the Kill Bill style, like, death punch?
Yeah, death punch. Like, a 1-inch punch, but it's actually he was dying anyway, so it just looks like...
So like you stab him and then you're like
bam. Yeah, like the secret is in the sauce, which is the side stab, and then I just punch him so I hit the top.
Yeah, and so as you jam your spear into his side and you kind of twist it, you feel a rib breaking as his hacking cough starts like ceases as it turns into a wheeze as your spear has punctured a lung, and as he drops to one knee and looks at you, you just sort of go like, boom, and palm right to the chest, and he just sort of slumps over as his metal armor hits the ground. Alright.
I go searching for a sword.
Okay, as he goes down to the ground, Douglas, I need you to make me a constitution save.
Sure. Actually, constitution is the one thing I still have. The constitution save is 15.
15 will do it. So you are going to sort of be hit by this nauseous wave of the stinking cloud, and you do manage to stave off like vomiting and retching for a whole turn, but you do know that you need to get out of this.
Nice. All right. In that case, I move out of the cloud.
Yeah, you can get out of there. All right. So as you get out, you see Nadia. She has, while you were doing this, she has dropped the final guard, the one that was kind of cowering in the corner, and is helping the like run out the door with the civilians that were trapped in here as the fire begins to spread.
All right. Is this like this tavern's gonna burn down? Right. There's no way.
Unless you somehow got a lot of people to act real quick, it's probably gonna burn.
I turn to Daelon and say, they're after me. We need to go. And I start, like, walking out of the tavern.
Okay. When are they not after you?
I'm like, good point. Carry on walking.
I'm going to try and escort some of the people out of the tavern.
Okay. Yeah, you can help.
Because I feel that my Molotovs are slightly responsible.
Like, as in the cause of the fire?
just a little bit. I mean, where else would the fire... No, the fire it came from somewhere else. I'm sure it was someone else's.
Has anything?
What's up?
Did the Frost Knight have anything for
you? Yeah, give me 1 second. We'll check. Real quick.
Kind of embarrassed, buddy. I feel slightly responsible for this.
So you look over the knight, you don't really have time to get his armor off of him. He obviously has the great sword on him and not much else. You saw him be sort of.
Take the great sword.
Okay, you can grab the great sword if you want.
Yay!
It's 2d6 actually.
I believe the great sword is 1d4.
Nope, I'm looking at it right now. 2d6.
Oh, this one is 2d6.
Which is better than a D12. He's, aside from his armor, which you don't really have time to take off, there's not a whole lot that he has. You saw him be kind of conjured in here, so he probably wasn't carrying anything with him.
Okay. I'll help the one.
Okay, so once you guys are outside and the tavern is in the process of catching fire, Nadia is going to she's going to kind of look at you, and when she does, I'm going to have to change my page here.
Nadia, you just butchered 20 men.
Yeah.
We've got to get the laundry in now. Oh, okay.
This is our dry mothering.
Thanks, Hitch. How's it going, Hitch? Or Hitch
is the new Mitch. She's kind of catching her breath. She says, "That was soldiers from the Pale Tower. They came here looking for the Black Rider."
All right. They're probably hunting me.
I don't think they knew about you until the leader of them used his mirror.
So I say, how do we get to the Pale Tower?
I can take you there. It's a little bit of a journey, but I can help you reach it.
Thank you. We need to go there to find souls.
Nothing else.
Definitely not saving the world.
She says, would you mind coming with me? I need to make sure my children are safe.
Can I before I leave the burning tavern, can I see if there's any ale that was...
You were pretty far away from the bar, but you could we'll say you could grab a mug off one of the nearby tables. It's not full, but it's like half.
Sinking a barrel so I could start bottling it again. But
you'd have to run into the burning building. My
stupid candy cart.
I turn back to Daelon. We need to go.
She, as you guys are walking back to Nadia's house, she says, "Everyone in town, I mean, they're thankful for you saving their lives, but we all know that as soon as that." What happened here will bring retribution down on this town. We need to go, and we need to stop the soldiers and Nazena as soon as possible.
Well, they're all miserable anyways. The blacksmith was a total dweeb, and the people of the tavern wouldn't even serve us booze, so they could go burn in the tavern, but I helped them, so...
I didn't. I let them burn.
Pat Douglas.
Good Douglas.
Patting him.
Take me to the Pale Tower.
So she nods. She says, "We will. We must outfit ourselves first."
With what?
As she's in her house, she kind of you see her sort of run over to her children who are still who are kind of hiding, and you know as she kind of leans down to embrace them, she says, "Now." Children, I'm going to leave you with your neighbor again. Your mother is going to travel for a little bit, but as always, I'll be back soon.
She might not come back.
Catherine just kind of gives you a slap in the back of the head.
As in, she might die.
Catherine just sort of grabs you by the collar and says, I think you should wait outside.
I just want to give them a proper risk assessment.
As that's happening, Daelon, you're sort of in this house. You hear a voice kind of coming from the right. It says, I can help. I can help.
I go over to the voice.
You kind of turn your head and you see that sitting on a shelf, like there's a shelf, like in the wall, and just sort of sitting on it is a small, it's what?
He's dead.
No, it's a small, like it looks like a small old man, like a tiny guy with a real long white beard. And like a little kind of cloth, like sackcloth cap, and he's just sort of sitting, like kind of hiding behind a jug that's on the shelf, and he says, "I can help."
You know, I could actually use some beard tips. You know, I'm not used to grooming something this lustrous, and I could see you have quite an incredible beard. I believe you can help me.
He looks at you confused. He says, No, with the tower.
So you don't have beard tips for me?
No.
I just walk away.
You get, as you're being pulled out, kind of Catherine will see that she says, What are you? And
Catherine's illogical.
You see Nadia kind of walks into the room. She says, you found him. That is Hatch. He's my domovoy.
He's your fuckboy?
No, domovoy.
Okay, that one's out of character. So I say, what is a domovoy boy?
It's...
Does he have a soul?
It's like a house spirit, I suppose. The little creature speaks up. He says, I used to live in the Pale Tower. I know how to get in. I know how to travel.
Do you have a soul?
I don't know. Do I?
Very well. He's passed the test. I say, you can come with us. Show us a way to the Pale Tower.
He says, the way is long, but once you get there is the problem. You need to get in. But that's not the only thing. The only way up is the teleporters.
Tell me more, little man.
They're made of ice crystal, specialized ice crystal. Nazena makes them herself. You need a password.
What's the password?
There's different ones to go up and to go down.
Tell me both.
Well, it's not just two. There's a lot of teleporters.
Tell me all of them.
right, for example, the first one at the first floor will take you up, and the password is, what is it? I got it, right.
The password is number one.
He says, a gathering within the hall. Take us one, take us all.
Okay.
And that will take you up.
I can't find a pen, so I'm just gonna pick him up and like,
we can really use your help, my friend.
He shakes his head, he says, I can't go in there. I'm too dangerous.
He's too small. I'm like, if he tries to resist.
Yeah, he's just like flailing in your arms.
Yeah, I'm gonna go over to the cart, and we're gonna find some sort of strap, make it out of cloth, and I'm gonna pretend it's like a hospital bed where they tie down their wrists, just kind of put it in the cart. A very tiny, like, amount of food next to him as well.
Nadia will kind of, she says, what are you doing to him?
Well, do you want to keep your town, and do you want your children to die?
She says, nothing, none of that requires you to tie this creature to restrain him.
He said he won't go back.
He said he won't go in.
Well, we need him in for all the stupid passwords.
She says, I can't. I've taken this creature into my home. I can't abide you forcing him to travel where he does not want.
Do you want your children to live?
Of course, but none of that requires.
I take my sword off. Do you want your children to live?
She kind of shoots you an angry glare.
I'm picking on a totally different wavelength than Daylon's on. So I'm like, right, we'll kill her kids. He has no soul anymore.
She says, you can't force this creature to travel back there if it is against his will.
And tell him to come with us.
Can I use my Patreon wild magic swords on Nadia?
Yeah!
I suppose!
Looking for, like, ways to buy my way
into this. Oh, Lord. Alright. Go ahead and roll a D10,000.
Yeah. £2 donation from Trainzy. Daelon wins the game.
Only $100, message.
Heroes like Lee's, who needs villains? True.
Alright, go ahead. So,
787, there we go, guys.
Alright, let me go down.
You can get a bunch of cool rewards for being a patron on Patreon, by the way, guys, if you didn't know. Some cool ways to interact with the show there. Actually cheaper, because pound is valued slightly more than the dollar, still. Still is.
She kind of, You see her kind of, her face kind of twinge a little bit, but she kind of like swallows, you know, as if her throat is very dry, but she kind of shakes her head and she says, No, look, Hatch, we'll travel with, I can tell him to travel with us, but once inside, you'll need to find a way to, she says, Hedge, can you tell us all the passwords that we need to know? And he says, Yes, I can tell you. Just don't take me back to Nezana. She'll hurt me.
Very well. That'll do for now.
You see her, as she's doing, like, the whole time, her throat looks, she looks kind of like she's kind of bothered a little bit by her throat. You don't know why.
So I say, is your throat okay?
Yes, just thirsty is all.
Have a drink.
What are you handing her?
Wine.
She'll
bourbon. She just downs.
She like kind of cringes a little bit. She says, thank you. I hope it's enough.
Follow the weird little guy. Let's go to the White Tower, or the Pale Tower.
He said he's not going.
Okay, White Tower. I think he's leading us there, but he's not going in.
No, she said she would lead you there.
Okay.
He can tell you the passwords and he can tell you things about the inside. He just doesn't want to go inside.
I don't have a pen near me, so it's...
So I say, lead us to the Pale Tower.
Wait.
You know the way to the Pale Tower. We've right. been there before.
Give me one second.
It's not far away. What's up, Ziggy?
All right. What's up?
Would you like me to write down the passwords, or
if you want to, it's up to you.
Kind of pretend that our PCs.
Well, you're definitely gonna need to disgorge them when the time comes. So you, if you want to ask Hatch for the passwords, he will tell you them. Tell you what he knows.
Yeah.
Okay. So he tells you that the first he says the first password on the first floor to go up is let me get back to my page. That has them on them, is a gathering within the hall, take us one, take us all. That's number one. And that's for, that works for both of them.
Take us one, take us all?
Yeah. He says, and if you want to go down from the same, one, you say, spiral downward to the ground, every ounce and every pound.
Okay.
And then he says, and that will take the. Then you're in the dining hall when you say, when you go up. After that, there's one across the hall, and that is. That's number 13. That is. God damn it, I lost my page.
What is it, little man?
He says, the 13. I don't know the password to that one. I used to. It used to be, up on the wind. Tread the air above the kin.
So, if you don't remember it, it's probably best if you come and kind of figure it out on the spot, right?
I agree.
Well, I can't figure it out. How would I figure it out?
You've been there. You know, you knew the passwords. You've understood the place.
I think you have to ask someone. You have to ask someone.
Who do we ask?
You just told us that you knew all the passwords.
I know some of them.
You said all.
Did you lie to us?
I read it wrong. He says, yes, the one on that one. It's onward, upward, in a tick. Don't be late. Just be quick.
I'll believe you for now.
He says, that one leads to the ritual area.
Yeah. How about that? Like ritual sacrifice, souls maybe.
Maybe. Not that they use the ritual area. I don't go there. He says. Also, the last one. It leads you up to the airy, where all the birds are. Very scary over there. It says, take wing, soar and fly. Let me view the winter sky.
Tell me, whereabouts in Pale Tower is this queen?
Probably all the way at the top.
So we need to go up, not down.
Yeah.
Right? Okay. Alright then. And I, anything else then?
A lot of guards there. Usually. Sometimes the people there, sometimes they're mean, sometimes they're not.
It's definitely some like car alarm. So I say, all right then. Well, they're after me as it is, so we'll run into them at some point. That's
he says.
Else we need to know?
If you find a woman. With blue skin, she was always nice to me.
Woman of blue skin. Nice and weird little guy. Got it.
She happened to be a cat at all?
No.
Okay, good.
It's chained.
So as you guys are doing this, Nadia will sort of hand you each a set of snowshoes. She says, we'll be traveling overland for about 6 miles. You may want these, though we can take my sled with the dogs. It will make travel quicker.
Okay. I say, very well, we'll take the dogs. Let's go. No time to lose.
All right.
With us.
All right. So you guys, is there anything you wanted to do before sort of Nadia is in the process of hitching up her cart and getting ready to set out?
I've got my equipment, my sword, we've got warm clothes, I think we're all good.
Okay, cool. So let me open Sirenscape because I want to. I want to put on some music that isn't this.
Yeah, I guess other than that, really, she should have dubbed it. Douglas just, like, stares out into the void for a bit, searching for a soul, doesn't find it there, and so...
He's looking within himself.
Yeah.
Stares out into the void.
Yeah. And deliberates to continue onwards to go and find this this pale... What's the queen's name again? What's her name?
The woman that you're looking for is Nezena. She is not the White Queen. She's just the
White Lady.
Yeah, one of the
White Wizards.
And then there's you're looking for Baba Yaga. Where is the ice one here?
Little BBY.
I'm trying to find the icy wasteland. There we go. Okay.
Represent
Baba Yaga.
All right, cool. So as you guys set out onto the onto the snow on Nadia's cart, she packs you guys onto the cart, and she whips the dogs, and they start going. As you set out across the icy wastes, it's what's up.
I attach my cart to the end of her cart.
You can attach your cart, so it's like bouncing along on the snow. Have you taken all the soda bottles off? Or are they just flying off?
We're riding in the back of that cart, so it's like the dogs, the initial car, and then the cart at the back with us on it.
We're gonna have like a really bro-y cheers with the party as we drink a soda.
Totally.
Like a Coca-Cola commercial or something.
Yeah, I drink it, but I taste nothing.
You lose your sense of taste, it's not fun.
Alright. What's up?
Like Barbosa, like, all manner of drink will not sate my lust.
It's going badly.
Alright, so as the carts are rocketing across the waste, the snow, and traveling. She said it was about 6 miles, which will not take you terribly long.
6 miles is all that.
But you can you guys make me a perception check, please?
No. Okay, actually, because I have my cloak of eyes, I'm at perception. Advantage on perception checks. So 13.
Okay. And
ooh, natty. But
and then let's just roll for Catherine.
We see everything there is to see.
Catherine rolls a zero.
Good work, Catherine.
A zero and a nat 20, which is pretty good. So as you guys are, Daelon, as you're whizzing by, you notice it's not coming near you, but you notice there's a fairly large crow that seems to have been following you in the air for quite some time now.
I want to throw my spear at it.
It's pretty far away.
Okay.
Like, it's not within spear throwing range. But you notice it's just been soaring through the blizzard, like, up in the air, and it hasn't really deviated from its path as it sort of follows you guys.
Is it a bird, you said?
What's up?
Is it a bird, you said?
A crow, yeah. A
crow. Interesting. Definitely not something in crows are always symbols of peace and hope in D&D. If you point out to me, I probably wouldn't say anything about it. It probably is just searching for my soul to
All right. So give me one second. Let me see if there's any music here.
Thanks for the spices. Congrats on hitting 2,700. Well deserved. Appreciate your words. How's it going, man? I love Daelon's instant reactions, throwing something at the cooking and sitting like, flapping along, having a lovely day, like, spear!
Yeah. Alright, so the crow doesn't seem to deviate, but after a while, another half mile or so, you guys see, you guys see that, off in the distance, basically standing upon a flat, snow-covered plain in, coming up over the horizon, is a huge tower. It's almost like a huge icy tower, covered in sharp battlements and walls. You can see that from the top of this tower you'd command a pretty solid view of the surrounding terrain. The sharp winds kind of whistle across this stark plain as you approach, stinging your eyes. Let me turn this down a little bit. Sort of stinging your eyes with the near blinding rays of the reflected sun. A great eruption of frozen ice rises in the distance, an imposing pale tower crowned with icicles spearing into the sky. Seemingly kind of born from the land itself, you see an unbroken circular wall of ice guards the tower's base, and as you're approaching, you don't even see a doorway in, and Eggy has donated $5 saying, "Hey Will, this gets you over 200%, shame that you something, I lost it."
You don't have to roll another wild magic search. What could possibly go wrong?
Alright, so while you do that, I'm going to read the rest of this. So, yes, thank you so much, man. So we'll go ahead and roll that wild magic, and
I will. I'm playing to Eggy later on. He's coming on the show, so I will punish you for this, don't
cool.
worry.
Cool. Alright, so,
later on, don't worry. Apparently the background music is a little bit loud.
Yeah, I'm turning that down a little bit. Seemingly born of the land itself, an unbroken circular wall of ice guards the tower's base with no means of entrance visible to you. High above, a large gash opens in the tower's bowl-like crown, ringed in icy spikes and split by a massive plane of ice, resembling an inverted crescent moon.
Nice. I say, what's that? So look at this. Clearly the pale tower.
She says, "Yes, that's Nezena's domain, the Tower of Ice." And you, what do you roll? I'm on the table here.
I rolled very low. I rolled 426.
426. Okay, cool. What? A sort of a twinge of melancholy hits you, Douglas, as you realize your parents were not married and you were an illegitimate child.
Why does he get all the emotional effects? Like,
oh my god, that's so sad. Douglas like looking off at the pale tower, and someone's like, Douglas, and like he's looking away out into the winds, and like just tears.
Just it rolls down his eye, and then it flies off in the wind and freezes as it goes.
And this like teardrop just lands, frozen teardrop just lands somewhere, and then it just like melts into the ground, just like Douglas's soul.
Kick him while he's down.
Man, you gotta kick him. Yeah, kick him while he's down, man. Egg, that is savage, man.
Oh man. Catherine just sort of pats you on the back.
I'm such a bastard.
So as you're riding, you kind of
Templeton. Oh my god, he's no longer Douglas Templeton.
Maybe that.
No, he is, but the name means nothing.
Yeah.
Maybe you discovered your anger issues.
Eggy has donated another $5. Says Will, that wasn't good enough. Let's try that again.
God damn it!
Oh lord, why?
Give me that gold money, and I'll roll that again.
Yeah.
Bastard. 7, 6, 7, 8, 7.
Making me fucking scroll around here.
God damn, Egg is just on a savage roll today.
Alright, 6, 7, 8, 7 is going to be and as this is happening, Will, your skin is going to sort of is gonna change to reflect your current emotion because your skin is dyed a paisley pattern.
Wait, what? My skin is now paisley.
Yes. You can choose what color paisley if you'd like.
I'm going for a blue paisley. I like a blue paisley shirt, actually, yeah. I will go for that.
Alright, so everyone sort of looks back at you and you haven't realized that your skin is now, like, covered in these swirling designs.
Oh my god. I'm like, Douglas is blue. Good lord, Gossy man, we're on the same. Oh man, so I just turn blue and I'm like, it's probably because I'm a bastard and have no soul.
Can I look out to see if I see a blue house or a blue window?
You see a blue tower.
Okay, does it have blue windows?
Oh my god, we got another one, and it says, Wolfman Rip donated $5, says Wild Magic Willy. Come on, I'm trying to get things done here!
Damn it, Wolfman.
Oh god, roll.
There's 5,081.
Thanks, Wolfman. Appreciate that. How are we on the roll? 5,081. Oh lord.
Fucking with Douglas right now. The guy is a bastard. He's turned blue paisley color, and he has no soul. What more can you take from him?
I'll tell you, it's cool because you can no longer be harmed from falling from any height.
How does that play out? Do I just like balance?
Because he's gonna try and.
You don't know it's true yet. But we will find out. I'm sure at some point.
He just jumps off. He's like, I have no family and no soul.
When he finally decides that at the top of the tower he's going to commit suicide by jumping off.
He tries to, but he just can't.
It's gonna be like the girl from Heroes.
Yeah.
He's just all day trying to throw himself off the tower.
God damn, that's so sad.
Oh lord. Okay, so moving right along, you guys are outside, sort of a little bit of a distance away. There's not really any place to shelter because this tower is in the middle of a flat, icy plain. But as you kind of come around it, there doesn't appear to be an entrance at all. There's just a solid wall of ice that encircles it.
Okay, I also wanted to say a quick thing, because I missed one. Now, if you guys are new, do hit that follow button and join us. We're also giving away D&D 5e starter set, so enter into the giveaway if you haven't already. And a huge thank you to you guys for like 200% of monthly funding. It's ridiculous. Super appreciated, guys. Thanks a lot. So we get to this pale tower. Douglas is a broken man.
And Eggy has donated $5 that says, you know what, once more for luck. We'll go ahead, I'm gonna put that off for a second because I do want to get through a little something, and then we'll get to the wild magic.
I'll roll it now.
Anyway, thank you so much, Eggy, and...
We're on this cart forever.
Does anyone else want to, anyone else? Let's just get it out of the way now.
2441.
Alright, we'll get to that. Oh man, thank you so much, Eggy.
Is there like an obvious gate or door or anything?
Not that you can see. Go ahead and roll me a perception check, please.
Alright, low advantage on this one.
Cool.
So I say, 14. I turn to Nadia. How do we get in?
She says, I don't know, I've never been here before.
Great.
Alright, so, No. Okay, cool. Will, you don't see an entrance. However, just sort of by the reflection of the light. By the way, if you want to, Daelon, you can make me a perception check too. And I will make one. Catherine.
Minus one.
And I will make one for Nadia because she has a perception. All right. The only none of you really can make anything out, but Hatch will kind of chime in. He'll say, there is a doorway, but it's covered in an ice spell.
An ice spell.
Yeah, and he kind of points, and you can see there is sort of a trail that is clearly left by people that are marching through this kind of plain of snow. They've sort of trampled a little bit of a pathway that leads towards the center of the ice wall, and he says, "You can't see it, but there's a hole in the ice wall, and you break through it, and then the spell makes the ice reform."
So we need to go through that hole.
You need to break through it, yeah.
How do we do that? Can we do that physically, or do we need some kind of magic?
You can use magic from the other side. But, I think you need to break through.
So,
if there's someone on the inside, they can open it for you.
So someone small, little, agile, probably knows his way around the tower.
I can't climb those walls. They're too tall.
Well, we can throw you.
No, don't please. No, please don't do that.
I just shake my head at him as if he's like not.
Nadia says, I have a pickaxe if it'll help us smash through.
Pickaxe is good. I'm the strongest one here.
Alright, well.
Are you?
Or I was.
I am
-2, never.
She kind of pushes you off the cart. She says, "Well then, let's get to smashing."
Don't just stay on despair. See episode title. So yeah, I'm gonna go up to and start just like smashing in. My strength is just like straight up a 11, so I've got a 0 in it.
Okay, cool.
The strongest of the party except for Nadia.
Catherine's
strong for
me. Oh, mom.
I totally didn't make a token for Nadia, and I should have. So here's what I'm gonna do. Let me just check something here. This is.
If this doesn't work, we'll throw the guy out.
Yeah, then.
Oh,
okay.
Thing to do.
Can I just thank everyone for this day? It's one of my favorite days of the week.
Douglas's day of despair.
Yeah. No, I mean, Thursday roleplay in general.
Alright. So you guys are. I'm gonna move you guys over to the map here. You guys are here. And then let me see if my Reign of Winter combat map works. It should. Yes, it does. Okay. And I'm gonna have to crop some stuff when I get there, but it'll work. Okay. So, that's where you guys are. Nadia is with you. I don't know if I have a token for her, but I will make one. What is a good... And so you... She kind of leads you to this, and Douglas, as you are kind of at the head of this, you can see that there's sort of an archway that's made of, like, runes that are carved into the ice, but inside this sort of arch of runes is just more ice.
Okay. So there's another room beyond where there's more ice inside, right?
What's up?
Just there's more just ice inside.
Yeah. So it looks to you, it looks like a solid wall of ice, but you can see there's like an archway that's of runes carved into the ice.
Okay. So I'm gonna turn to Kira, Catherine, and say, "Do you think you could use some like fire magic on it or something? You know, like weaken it up a bit."
She says, I could, but, wrong person, sorry. She says, I could use my fireball, but I don't want to, I need to save the spell in case we need it later.
Yeah.
She says, if you should try smashing it, and if it doesn't work, I'll blast it.
Okay, so I'm gonna start smashing.
Okay, cool. And let me get a Nadia on here. Let me get her character sheet. Nadia is also going to throw a strength check to help you smash it. Do you want to use a strength check or do you want to use a weapon attack?
Weapon attack.
Okay, go ahead and roll it. I'm not gonna you don't have to roll to hit, because it's just go ahead and roll me some damage.
Sure. In that case, I'll have to roll this.
So it is one damage.
Alright, so you and Nadia both kind of swing your weapons in concert, and there is a crash as you both hit the... let me just check the... Yeah, okay. Wow, okay. No, that's the wrong thing.
Yeah, I'm just gonna keep.
You smash into it, and she is, she's gonna like she, you hear there's like a your weapons impact, and there is like a cracking of ice. It's not enough to shatter the wall, but it is a little bit of so if you want to keep throwing strength at it, you can.
I'm gonna keep just beating away at this thing. I mean, he's got a lot of rage, and he's got no soul, so basically he's just gonna keep. Slashing in.
Yeah.
It's four.
Yeah, she's just gonna straight up make a strength check. No,
I would make a strength check, but it's just a
T-tool. Alright, so as your next kind of impact smashes into it, that's 10 and then 12 and it's okay, yeah. And as you smash it again, the crack that you already hit into it kind of widens a little bit, and you see the ice sort of, the crack sort of splinters out, and as it splinters out, it basically stops right at the edge of where that arch of runes is. And then she's gonna say, she says, throw your shoulder into it! And she's going to kind of rear back and kind of make a strength check to shoulder charge it. If you want to help her out, you can.
Cool. Strength check looks like just flat
the toilet. All right. Well, luckily your assistance is going to help her as you both kind of slam your shoulder into it, and the wall of ice is like that in this archway is just going to kind of come crashing in, and you see before you as the wall comes crashing in. I don't know what. Oh, those are lights. Sorry, that should be in the GM layer. You can see a courtyard spread before you. However, there's basically almost like a portcullis made of icicles. And holy shit, I forgot to switch. Never mind. I forgot to switch to the combat map. Basically, you see a portcullis in front of you that's made of icicles.
I say, Catherine, you might want to do your thing.
I just switched to the...
Is there kind of like any like mechanism to it, I wish I could see?
No, it's just, you don't see anything to it. And I, by the way, people on stream are going to see I accidentally switched to the Strahd combat.
So, I'm going to say, we can try and pick our way through. I'm going to go in. I'll give it a smack. Does it do anything? To make will roll for following. Welcome to the adventure. You are a gentleman and a scholar. Guys, it's gonna go easy on your old boy Will here. Douglas is a broken man, yo. Dear me. So can I make this like a strength check or something?
Yeah, you can. While I try and get Will's camera back. I forget which one. Nope. Not that one. Times 3, is it?
Right.
Nope.
Not yet.
Which one is it?
Is that one?
Nope. That's the wrong one.
I'm gonna roll a strength check.
Go ahead and roll me the strength check.
Yeah, sure. That is 8. I'm so strong, guys. I'm so big and strong. I used to be big and strong.
It is one. That's one. Oh, fuck it. I'll fix it later. Okay. So you, I'm on the RP map for now. As you do it, Nadia is going to throw a strength check in with you as she tries and cracks through this. You guys are sort of kicking, and it's not doing anything. Catherine will say, let me help, as she is going to kind of conjure her Eldritch Blast and blast this thing with a nat 20 for some force damage.
There we go.
As the force damage is going to shatter some of the icicles. And also, I missed that donation, I'm sorry.
Thanks so much to Eggie. He donates £5 again and says, I think Douglas can be a bit more broken. Not quite enough yet. Jesus Christ.
Alright. So
two,
as you...
Two that you have
for yeah, you go ahead and you roll it, and I'm going to get back to Wills now. As you, Douglas, as you... Wait, did you say Douglas or Daelon?
Douglas.
Oh my god, I got to do two for you now.
6-5-6-4 was that one.
Okay, what was the last one?
Last one was 2-4-4-1.
2-4-4-1. So as you're sort of stepping through this cloud of fog and shattering this ice, you are going to, this is hilarious, but you don't know it yet. So your blood, you don't know this right now, but your blood is not blood anymore. It is something called universal solvent. It dissolves glue.
Ah, that's good.
And here's a hilarious thing, and that your characters don't know, but I'm gonna let you guys in on it because I was a little bit vague about it before. The random thing that happened to Nadia in her house, she, much like Catherine, thirsts for holy water. She thirsts for universal solvent.
Really?
She's a vampire.
No, she doesn't. She's not a vampire, but if Will should ever start bleeding in front of her, things will get weird.
As universal solvent pours out.
Let me get the other one now. Oh god.
The other one was 6-5-6-4.
And here's a funny thing. I thought I was gonna get too much done in this session.
That's always a worry.
6-5. Where are we now?
Will run, yeah. I just look at Catherine, she's after me, and run.
No, you don't know it yet.
I know.
But maybe in the future. Where are we? 6-5.
Like my blood might feel different.
I don't know. Yeah, you can't really feel your blood. And also, Will, this is strange, and you don't know why, but. In the last couple days, when you wake up, like, you've gone to bed normally, but when you wake up, you're just sort of sitting in, like, that meditating lotus position.
Right. Wait, when I sleep, I'm...
When you wake up.
Then wake up, I'm in the lotus position.
Yes, you wake each day seated in the lotus position. It's just a thing you've been doing.
Okay.
Meditating on soullessness.
Oh my god.
I'm so broken, guys.
Who is this character anymore? So as you come crashing through the gate, you guys are... Normally you would take cold damage, but I'm gonna say the magic is enough for you guys. You find yourself looking in on we're in the courtyard now. Find yourself looking on a courtyard where sort of a massive ice sculpture of a dragon dominates this open courtyard, standing with raised wings upon a dais of solid ice. 7 squat wooden shacks are sitting around the courtyard here, with several dog sleds stored outside of them, and between them, 4 sort of chutes of ice descend from the battlements of the outer wall, while directly across the courtyard from you guys, you can see large doors studded with icicles lead inside the pale tower itself, just beneath an overhang of sharp icicles dangling from above.
Okay. Remember what happened last time Daelon touched the statue? Yeah. I like, do not touch that statue, Daelon. Do not want. Do not want. So I'm gonna say, Tantanalia, how do we get up? We need to find, like, a elevator.
She says, up? What do you mean?
We need to get up to the top of the tower.
We'll need to go inside, I think.
Make a good point.
Just gonna walk forward.
she makes a strong case for going inside. Yeah. And inside. What's up, Dr. Pedro? Let's get this.
All right. So as you guys want to cross the courtyard.
Yeah. Cross the courtyard inside is flat.
Cool. Let me just add my Twitch alerts browser source on this. There we go. Okay, cool. And as you guys are going to you are welcome to step inside. You can control your own tokens. As you do, you see sort of stepping out from behind one of the huts is something similar to what you've seen before. As you make your way in, you see a large sort of a large figure. It looks like a step out from the huts, and it kind of growls a sort of a bone in its hand as it sort of tears a frozen chunk of flesh off of it. Says,
"I knew I was waiting for new meat."
Brad Wodo, is Reign of Winter a homebrew campaign? Not really. It is actually a Pathfinder adventure path, but we've changed it quite a bit.
Yeah, and it's kind of set in our own homebrew kind of world, I suppose. It follows on from our last series as well. And thanks so much to NetRPG for following. Welcome, my friend, to the adventure. You're a gentleman and a scholar. Thanks for joining us today.
All right, so as this ice troll is stepping out from behind the hut and putting its sights on you, you guys know that this, like, clearly, this is the defense, like, this is put here to defend. We're gonna go ahead and roll some initiative.
Yeah, I say stand back, looks like we're in trouble. Dramatically.
Yeah.
This token's awesome, by the way.
Yeah, let's find some music here.
Let's do it. Some So yeah, we're gonna step forward. Like, he's realized that his in the space of a few moments, he's got no soul. His parents are not really his parents, and it's gonna be bad for him. So he's just gonna step forward. Except he's kind of like one of the slayers from like Warhammer fiction now. He's like looking for a worthy death at this point, I think.
The
like,
servitors.
He's forgot about his wife Claudia back at home, who he's. Since he left, he said, I'm going away for 3 days, love. I'll be right back. He turned into a kobold. He turned into a bronze dragon. He lost his soul. And now he's in an ice tower fighting some fucking troll. He's had a bad week.
Solvent blood.
Solvent blood. Will, look behind you. Do you have an exit from this place? Yes? In real life?
They do. They just sort of... They just came in, so why don't you guys go ahead and throw me some initiatives as we dive right into here. Nadia will, of course, throw her own initiative, which is not on here, so... Dex. That's not what Nadia looks like, by the way. That's... Wow, she gives a 1.
Yeah, we're using Sirenscape on this one.
It's a mix of Sirenscape and tabletop audio.
Gonna knee Claudia in the face every time you wake up, like next to her in your.
awaken in the lotus position.
Yeah, you wake up in the lotus position in the interface.
I orange draw initiative, sorry, my bad.
He gets a 5. Wow, I'm rolling low on initiative today. You are never going.
I am literally the worst.
Alright, and...
If it's -1, is it like, you skip a turn?
He's gonna go, wow, we all suck. Except Daelon.
We are the worst, it's confirmed.
We cannot roll today, so... is it Douglas? No, I put that in the wrong one. Douglas is at 0.
Yeah, I'm at 0.
And Daelon is at 16.
I'm just frozen in time and space at this point.
Okay, so Daelon, you see this giant troll emerging. What do you want to do?
I'm gonna panic and throw my spear.
Okay.
And I want to thank Just In Case for following. Welcome, my friend, to the adventure. You're a gentleman and a scholar. Thanks for joining us today.
Let me just, by the way, how many retweets are we on?
That's a good point. 15. If you haven't retweeted already, check out those retweets. 25, you guys get to decide what happens in the game, so be sure to hit that retweet button if you're interested in doing it.
How do you get a 0 initiative? By failing at life. That is exactly how it does. So you want to make, you can make two attacks, but you technically can't throw your spear twice unless you have a second spear, which I think you do. But only one of them is a man-catching spear. So you just want to... You want to throw both of them?
Yeah.
Okay, so both of these spears come sailing through the air as you emerge. And let me just check this thing's AC, which I'm pretty sure... Yeah, that'll hit it. So go ahead and roll me the damage as both these spears just come sailing through the air and land in this troll.
Get absolutely wrecked.
And then we'll put this on screen so people can see it.
Alright, 6 damage.
Okay. Cool. And he has... Okay. So, you are going to do 6 damage to the troll. As your spears chunk right into its body as it...
How big exactly is this troll?
It's about the same height as the last one you fought, which was about 8 or 9 feet tall.
Wow, we just get Freddy's trolls, don't we?
Yeah, you remember you fought one outside the portal. Daelon, do you want to move or do you want to stay where you are?
I'm just going to kind of stare at it and just look at my hands that are now spearless and look back up at it. So both my spears are launched now.
Yeah.
Oh, well.
It's all right. I'll get him later. You gonna say where you are? Okay, cool. The troll is going to go, and it is going to... Let me check something real quick. Okay. The troll is going to charge forwards, just sort of bounding. 5, 10, 15, 20.
It's almost as if we've got some kind of massive nerve 25.
Alright, Douglas, the troll is going to rush towards you, and it is going to make some claw attacks. Let me just, it is going to make 2 claw attacks here.
23 and 18 are both hits.
Alright. You're going to take 10 damage.
Okay. It's okay. I'm looking for his death now, so it's alright.
Alright. And as we move to Catherine, are we... Yeah, there's nothing I can do about it, unfortunately. It's gonna come up on the screen. I don't have a second screen for troll stats. Maybe I can pop it out. I don't know. Let me see if I can... Yes, I can. Oh my god. There we go.
Incredible.
I can pop that out. Okay, cool. So, and while I'm doing that, let me pop out Catherine's sheet too then. So I can do this. Catherine is going to step backwards. She's going to say, "Remember, it's weak against fire!" As she is going to cast her Scorching Ray.
We burned down the tavern before we cut up and left.
Scorching Ray, or... No, she is going to cast her Fireball at the troll. So, cast at what level? 3rd? Yes. The troll has to make a dexterity save.
I'm pretty enraged that you don't have a screen dedicated to troll stats, honestly.
I need to buy a new monitor for that.
You do.
And
I'll
the
special
overlay.
The troll is going to make its dexterity save, so it is going, but it doesn't matter because it is fire damage and it takes double fire damage anyway. So as this fireball just explodes against the troll and sets it on fire, the troll is going to scream in pain. So that is a whole bunch of damage on that, and she says, "It can't regenerate while it's on fire." And Nadia is going to jump in right here, and she is going to also. I'm going to
carrying the team this episode. She already is.
Well, you guys wouldn't need to be carried if Touchpad hadn't killed you.
It's true.
She. And Wolfman is going to throw another $5. Says, "Troll-a-lol-a-lol." I don't know if that means the troll.
It's up to you, Wolfman. Do you want to go on a troll?
It's up to you, because there is a troll on screen.
God.
So she's gonna make her two sword attacks as this goes on. A 22 and a 17 are both going to hit. And she's going to make she's going to carve into this troll for a couple of damage. Was that? That is 13? Yeah.
Wolfman says roll for it, so...
Wolfman says roll for it, so he wants... I'm going to... You know what? We'll roll for whoever's on screen. So I've got Troll is 1, Nadia is 2, Daylon's... Douglas is 3, Daylon's 4, and Catherine is 5. That's right, how we'll do it.
So
you
want to
go for
troll.
It? Yep. Troll! Alright! The Woo. Troll is going to get a wild magic surge as he is hit by this fireball for 1,170. Let's go and see exactly what that means for the troll.
Oh.
Oh, the troll then.
Alright, 1,170. Oh, the troll basically, the troll is going to be... He looks like... You see his skin kind of shrivel up and turn into, like, a mask of burn scars.
Nice.
Makes sense. Just good.
That makes perfect sense.
Alright. So, he is not looking very... Not looking good. It's actually a she. It's not looking good as the Nadia lays into it with the sword. Its regeneration is not going to help it this round. So as we move on to you, Douglas, what do you want to do?
I'm going to run up to it. We're being trolled right now, mate.
Yes, you are.
I'm going to run up to it. I don't even need to, because I'm right next to it. And I'm going to swing at it twice with my greatsword now.
Go for it.
Great sword. It really is pretty great. So a 16 and a 7.
The 16 will hit.
For 8 damage.
Cool man. 8, that's going to be...
Pretty red.
Okay, how do you want to do this?
I'm going to swing it up and, like, bring it down into its leg to kind of cut down at its thigh. With this big kind of great swing down on its thigh. It's kind of like kneecap almost. You know?
Alright, so you bring as you kind of bring your sword around, the troll, it smashes the troll's knee and it goes down to one leg, and as it looks up to you, you see its neck exposed, and you have the chance, like, you're the one who's gonna finish, you've got the finishing blow here.
Oh nice, in that case, I kind of cut down its kneecap, the leg comes down, it falls down, with a great kind of thud, and then I just kind of executioner style over the shoulder,
just
down the head, yeah.
Like Game of Thrones.
Yeah.
Just
yeah. Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Right down, and the troll, its head flops off. Unfortunately, you know, the fire's still burning around it. It is not able to catch it. You know, to help itself as a gout of blood just sprays out along the snow, and that troll is destroyed.
Nice. We got trolls until the end. So in this room, is there an obvious way up that we're looking for?
So you're not in a room. You're in a courtyard.
Okay. So, yeah, I've got it. Yeah. So I'm gonna move forwards inside of it, basically, like Nadia suggested before.
Okay. So Nadia will kind of pull her sword out. She says, "Looks like those are the doors over there."
Take both my spears.
Yeah, you wrench them out.
Put them back. It was super intentional.
All right, so you make your way under this sort of over, like, this balcony with these huge icicles that hang down as you sort of duck under them, and you make your way to these two large doors that are covered in protruding spikes of ice. The spikes of ice won't actually prevent you from opening the doors. It seems like they're just there to be imposing more than anything else.
That'll look cool. So, I want the doors. Push on through.
Alright, give me 1 second.
We need to go deeper. We need to find a soul. Or a soulmate. I need a soulmate.
Soulmate? To steal their soul?
Yeah, I need to steal their soul.
Soul type. AB positive.
Alright, so as you grip these doors with Nadia, and you haul them open both at the same time, you guys, let me delete that too so you guys can walk through easily. You see the light is sort of emanating on a hallway beyond.
Running. I just start sprinting.
Okay, you can control your own token, by the way.
I feel like I'm...
Wow, you are fuzzy as hell.
Right now,
yeah. Drunk goggles.
Yeah.
I think Trinity's cam is drunk.
Drunk
goggles. Remember what's happening in my cam.
It's
trying
to
also
focus
itself. Alright, so Daelon, as you were as you were barreling in, you see basically you can kind of skid to a halt as this you're in a room full of like steamy air, I should probably put light here too, because there definitely would be. As you enter, just give me 1 second. Paste some light. There we go.
Kira's living in a dark cave right now. Yeah, her camera's just really dark, really bad lighting, and Kira's...
Yeah, it's a problem.
Yeah. It's just, that's what it's like in Canada.
Okay, so as you enter this sort of steamy air fills this inner gallery, you can see emanating in lazy wisps from this bubbling pool that is recessed into the floor of a raised dais. That's what the blue rings are. They're steps leading up, surrounded by 6 pillars of ice. And around you, they're outlined in pink. You can see 4 foggy mirrors hang from walls near ice sculptures of helmeted pike wielding warriors. Oh, I don't know what that buzzing sound is.
Is it for me?
No, it's coming from me. Go ahead. Don't worry about it.
Right. So coming in here. Don't touch anything. We need to find a way to get up here. Okay.
I'm gonna take some of the steamy water and put it on my face.
Don't touch anything. So I say to Catherine, you are a warlock. Why don't you get us up? We know the password.
She says, he said the teleporters were made of ice. This is a pool of water. And as she turns her head, she points, she says, but maybe it's one of those, and she points over here, where you see these large kind of deep blue, kind of crystalline structures. It looks like sort of a platform with like crystals sort of growing up in an X pattern.
Okay, I'm gonna head over here.
Okay.
Closer inspection, is there anything else I notice about?
Yeah, give me 1 second.
Sure.
So a glassy pattern of striated crystalline ice covers the tiled floor in this open alcove, illuminated by a soft blue light.
How do I make it go up?
Try the password, I guess.
Yeah, okay, in that case, I say the words, I've written them down.
I walk up, let it go confidently.
A gathering within the hall takes us
one.
One takes us all.
All right, Douglas or Daelon, you as you step onto the tiles and you speak the words, Douglas, you're gonna see him just in sort of a flurry of snow. You see him disappear. Daelon, you are going to land. Let me give you a torch. You are gonna land here. Nope, don't need to. Just need to move him to the front. Alright, so you, Daelon, you are sort of, you land in a chamber, which I'm sure you can see. It's got a large, like a large curved table and a hallway after a short set of steps. Nadia is gonna kind of rush up behind you. She says, was that the teleporter? Did it work?
Yes. I'm gonna go on and say the words.
Okay.
So I say, gathering within the hall, take a swan, take us all.
Cool.
Does it understand accents?
What it understands is the Doc of Pepper donating $5 says, butts, Viking butts.
A lot of Viking butts.
That's a lot of Viking butts. I have no idea what it means, but it is a lot of Viking butts.
A lot of Viking butts. Thanks so much, Dogger Pepper. Let me give you that gold, buddy. If you want to use it in a way that you give players nat ones, that sort of stuff, then you can go and do it that way.
Douglas, you arrive right there.
Okay. So I say, Daelon, don't run off.
Just kind of slump.
Now.
An excited thing.
I run off.
Just gonna follow, saunter behind.
Okay. Quickly, let me just grab their tokens. You will see Catherine and the other two will kind of poof into the room, saying, "Oh, is that how the teleporters work?" Let's take a second, because as you were walking through the room in number 8, you basically, you see there's this crescent-shaped dining table that occupies this Y-shaped chamber, while two large mirrors on the north and south walls kind of create the illusion of an even larger space. About 20 feet overhead, you can see an immense chandelier of ice crystals hangs from the ceiling, while to the east of you, which is the direction you guys are heading currently, these sort of rounded steps access a short hallway that is flanked by twin ice sculptures of dryads that are holding sort of ice-carved tree limbs that create an elaborate archway.
I'm gonna go touch one of the statues.
Okay. It is cold. It is, you know, a little bit wet to the touch, but it's frozen solid. You can see sort of translucent glass-like double doors are set in the hall's north and south walls, while to the that was where you came from. Never mind. Yeah, so just there are sort of translucent glass-like doors here and here, as well as another set of icy double doors here.
Just follow Douglas.
Double doors for me, I think. I'm gonna head for the double doors.
Okay.
These would look important.
Well, that is not... You can't forcibly change my donger.
I'm afraid I have. It's not 2 inches, man. I've announced it.
Alright, so which set of doors are you investigating?
The ones up here.
Okay, cool. The ones set... Okay, yeah. Those are... I don't think those are locked. Let me just... My notes?
That was right direct, man. He just wants to get to the... To solve it, basically.
Yeah. I got you, man. So yeah, as you push open these two doors, you find yourself looking into a room with a long red carpeting that extends from the western doorway of this mirrored hall between ice sculptures of twin nymphs, ending in an open alcove to the east. You can see passageways continue to the north and south, following the contours of the outer wall, where windows look out over the courtyard below.
I'm gonna go to these windows.
Okay, the window is all the way over here.
Okay, so I'm gonna look in here. This thing here, is this like a teleporter?
Yeah, that is another, like, sort of, there's, like, a section of the floor that is set with these glassy blue ice crystals that glow softly.
I say to Daelon, I go stand on it. I motion for Daelon and Nadia to stand on with me. I say, Daelon, you wrote down what that password was, the second one, right? Right? Somewhere. You're muted, so I can't hear you.
Yeah. Onward, upward, in a tick. Don't be late, just be quick.
Do we go up?
You standing on the teleporter?
Yeah, standing on.
There is... nothing happens.
Take wing, soar, and fly. Let me view the winter sky.
Nothing happens. And this time, actually, there is sort of a blast of cold that is going to cause you to freeze for... two damage. As you sort of are jarred back by this sort of these ice crystals just growing on your chest as you're hit by this blast.
I'm gonna like dust myself off.
This clearly isn't the right one. What is that? Let's try one of these doors. I'm gonna get this one here. See what's inside of it.
Okay. As you open this door, you find yourself looking into a hallway with a couple more doors leading off of it.
Okay. Gonna head into this hallway, follow it around. Can I open each door as it comes, I suppose?
Okay. I'll just give you a rundown. The first thing, the first door you're going to open will lead you to, which will be right here, will lead you to a bedroom. And inside, I'll give you a quick description of it. That's 11. You're sort of hit by the scent of perfume that fills the air of this small bedroom, where several dresses styled for some sort of a noble woman lie sort of arranged on the bed, and in a chair sitting at a mirrored vanity appears to be a woman. A very familiar woman. You appear to be looking at the at Lady Argentia.
Really?
Turns her head to you and she says, who are you?
We've met before, Lady Argentia.
She says, I don't know what you're talking about.
Are you Lady Argentia?
Of course I am. They captured me and brought me here.
Were you, you captured last time?
We already saved her.
She,
we already met you.
She kind of, she says, that must have been the one they sent to be my double.
What do you mean, your double?
They were going to replace me.
Why?
I don't know. To help the witch spread her influence, I think.
I don't know if I believe this. I can roll an insight check to see if I believe it.
Go ahead and roll me an insight check.
Sure.
I'll give you advantage on it.
Okay. My insight is awful, of course. 14.
You're not really sure. I mean, there's, like, it looks like the Lady Argentia, it sounds like the Lady Argentia, the mannerisms, like, the way she's talking is slightly different, so, you really have no way of knowing, but, this one seems sort of nervous and definitely doesn't know who you are.
So, I say, I turned to Daelon. Is there anything that we know about Lady Argentia that nobody other than her would know? I've got an idea. I've got an idea. So Douglas like gets his sword and he like goes to swing and he's gonna like stop it just at her neck and see if she like turns into like anything like ah! Or like.
Okay, are you attempting to intimidate, or are you actually attempting to attack?
I'm going to attack, but I'm going to stop just short of my neck.
I'm going to, go ahead, first of all, go ahead and roll me an attack roll, and then go roll me a strength check to see if you, actually a dexterity check, to see if you can stop your blade before it hits her.
11. Next.
you attempt to sort of check your swing, but it is... It is not enough as you pull your sword back and it is just gonna clip her. Roll me some damage.
Oh man, I'm the worst. 7 damage.
It could work out.
All right, you don't kind of chop her head off, but you do sort of cleave, like catch her just as you try and pull the sword back. It is pretty heavy as it kind of clears through, like cleaves through her shoulder, and she screams in pain and falls out of the chair.
My like, you know, Douglas, soulless as he is, he just doesn't care. He's like, okay, she's good.
And give me one second. This creature, this woman falls out of the chair and kind of rolls on the ground. You see sort of a almost a shimmer or something like in her facial features. They distort as she's going to reach for your leg and try and pull you off balance. And as she grabs your leg and tries to trip you, we're gonna roll some initiative.
Oh, damn.
All right, so I have to. I didn't actually put this in, so let me check something here. There we go. Okay.
Okay. So let's see here. So she's attacking me, so maybe she is bad. Huh? We never killed bad people, so yeah. Ogres has only ever killed bad people before. This
yeah.
is true.
This is new experience.
All right. So, as we do that, what is that? Oh, that's the rolls thing. Okay. So why don't we go ahead and roll some initiative? Where's Catherine? Catherine's here. Add turn and get some initiative on that. 18, and of course Nadia will get an initiative, and I don't have a token for the lady, so let's use this one.
You might want to move the roll 20 screen down the stream so folks can see what we're up to.
Oh yeah, it's right there. Add a turn for her.
The support we used was a cat bat. He lied to us about everything. The cat lied to us about everything. Literally everything.
Everything in the world.
In what ways was the cat? In what ways wasn't it?
Exactly. Always was that cat good. It was like, oh,
it's actually bad.
His voice was just so bad.
I've discussed it a little bit on other streams, but it's like, if you generally want the player, like, it very rarely does an antagonistic ally work out well.
Yeah.
Like if you want your players to be sympathetic to an ally, don't make them like piss the players off.
Douglas is a pretty easy man to piss off, but when you like lie to him about his wife,
oh, yeah.
Like, you know, like he's
all right. So Catherine will go first, but she has no idea what's going on. Douglas, you are actually in the room here. As she's gonna
bad.
Sort of,
she's probably bad.
She's gonna step into the room and she says, "What are you doing? Why are you attacking her?"
She attacked us first.
She's
whoa.
I don't believe you at all.
Good.
Good.
And she is going to
try to see if she's evil. The only way was to attack her, and look, she's attacking me now.
It's like Austin Powers when he's pulling the wig off of him.
Alright, she's gonna hold her turn until something happens. Daelon, what do you want to do?
I am.
And she'll probably be back here.
I'm just immediately gonna come up and, you know. It seems like if Douglas was willing to attack, then I could
do with
attack as well, yeah.
Seems reasonable to me.
Yeah, so I'll go in with a double spear
attack. Let me throw some music on, I totally forgot. Alright, so you wanna step in and attack?
Yeah.
Alright, go for it.
So 17 and 8.
A 17 will, yeah, you can hit with that. Holy shit, my phone. No, don't want that.
So Will of course announces every move. Will found that a bit tiring after a while. Will found that the comedic effect of announcing his all of his moves lessened.
Yeah.
Alright, so as you kind of spear down in, let me just check something real quick. How much? A little bit.
So
okay.
I do 1d6 of unarmed damage, and I can do one additional unarmed attack every turn.
Okay, so that's 9 total.
Oh damn! Yeah. 6.
Okay, cool. So you spear this creature, this woman on the ground. Anything else?
None.
All right.
Spear and just kind of like jab, just looking over at Douglas and looking down like, yeah, this is good, right?
She's bad.
the woman is going to make a, she's gonna, she doesn't have any melee weapons, unfortunately, so she is going to
If it turns out she's a normal person, I'll probably try and stop her.
She is going to slam into you twice.
Try being the operative word.
A 20 and an 18.
Both for hits. Goddamn, she's gonna wreck me.
4 and 6.
Ah. Yeah, pretty good though.
As she kind of, she like, oh, no, wait, I'm sorry. One of those, only one of those is gonna, because the first thing is she's gonna make a strength check. She doesn't trip you. So, that was the first thing she did.
Ask her, just no strength doppelganger is.
Oh, yeah. It's, there's nothing I can do about it. It's, no, I could change it, but I totally forgot to.
No, it's all good.
Yeah.
So, is she, what is she attacking with? Just punch me?
Yeah, hands.
Does she seem like feral?
What's up?
Does she seem like feral in any way?
She's
or like...
definitely fighting for survival at this point. How do you want to respond?
I'm trying to think now. I think bonus is if he's hit her and he isn't immediately convinced that she's a monster, he's probably going to stop.
Okay.
So it's kind of like he didn't mean to attack her. Right?
Yeah.
And so like now that she attacked back, he's like, okay, she's fine, because she didn't like turn into Wally Ripley or something like
okay.
that. Okay. So he's gonna, I'm gonna like stop and I say, whoa, it's okay, I thought you were bad. Turns out you're alright.
Alright. So
I don't know, it's sort of, I'll take it against you, she sends my way, but...
Alright.
And she's not an evil person because she hasn't turned into anything.
Nadia will say, what's going on? Who is this? You were talking to this person.
This is Lady Argentia. Turns out she had a double before. It wasn't a real one we met last time.
Catherine is going to take her turn at this point.
Catherine just fucking like fireballs in the room.
No. What she's going to do is, she's going to say, interesting. I don't know what that is. I'm just looking at our spell list. Okay.
Maybe fireball is on you.
No, not fireball. Spell list.
Consider it.
Yeah. So she's gonna say. We'll find this out. And she is going to cast, like, as she conjures, she's going to cast Charm Person on the woman. And the woman is going to make a Wisdom saving throw. 10 is not enough. And as she does, she says, you tell us who you really are. Are you really the Lady Argentia? And the woman will kind of back up to the wall. She says, no. My name is Gorak.
Her name is Borat.
She says, I am Gorak. They were training me to impersonate her.
So the one we met before was the real one. We can kill her. I turned to her, what do you know about this place? Passwords, where the queen is, white woman, Zera. Tell me all of the things, all of them. Every last thing. Do you have a soul? I'll just barrage him with questions.
He says, Nazena and Radosek were using me for their plans.
How?
I was going to impersonate the woman and make it so her home country did not send soldiers to stop the portal.
Oh, okay. That makes sense now. Okay, that's cool. So tell us more about Nazena, and who's this Radosek guy?
Radosek is...
sounds pretty rad.
Nazena's lieutenant. He is in charge here while she is away.
Is she away at the moment?
She left for White Throne days ago.
Why is she going to White Throne?
I don't know. She does not tell me.
Do you have any ideas?
Yes. I think that is where her plan will unfold.
So Radosek is here. I'm guessing he's a guy we should take out. Where is Radosek?
At the top of the tower. He knew you were coming. At
how
some point, he shut down the teleporter.
How do we turn it back on?
You don't. Only Jairus has the key.
Who is Jairus?
A sylph woman. She lives in the Aerie.
Right, so how do we get up to the Aerie?
The teleporter at the other side of the tower.
Lead us there.
He says, just very well, just don't kill me.
Not yet, no.
Go ahead and make me an intimidation check, please.
Okay. Believe it or not, I'm not the most charismatic guy. 18, though.
18, yeah. He is cowering in fear of you as you hold your sword to him. So you want to, he will sort of drop the disguise of the lady, and you see him return to this sort of pale-looking, sort of look like a gray alien kind of thing. Like, not really, not a lot of form to his face. Features kind of plain and, you know, not really... they don't really look like anything. So as he can... if you'd like to let him, he can lead you.
Yeah, I'll let him lead us, sir.
Okay. So let me, so he will, just for the sake of expediency, he will take you guys out of the, let me turn auto there and end combat. He will take you out of, back into this room here, that you guys came through, and over through this door over here. Not like that,
So I'll also remind those folks whilst we're...
yeah, go ahead.
If you're new, do hit that follow button. If you're enjoying the show, then do join us. We have 5 nights a week, 10 shows a week, 150 hours of D&D every single month. We've got another 24-hour stream coming up about this time next month. Look forward to what we're doing every month. We're also giving away a copy of the D&D 5E starter set, so go ahead and enter into that. If you haven't already, exclamation point giveaway is a way to find that link. Other than that, let's get these retweets going.
Yeah, how are we doing on that, by the way?
Get to site. I think we're around, let's have a look here, 18 at the moment. It's already 7 away. So let's get some madness going, guys. And screw with the party even more. Of course, we've got another game starting at 4 p.m. here. We're playing a new season is starting, actually. A new show is starting. So, thanks, Buddy College. That's all.
Yeah, go ahead and hit that retweet, because we are coming up on the end of the show real quick. We've got... I don't know, we've got about 35 more minutes here. And when we do, it would be really cool if you guys sent us a viewer decision just as the show ended, because those are the most dramatic ones, as you know. But hit that retweet, help us out.
Let's get it going.
Real cool.
Yeah, and a new show at 4 as well, which is exciting.
Oh, yeah. All right. So, as we wait for... Trainzy to get back here. I have a phone call that I'm going to...
I'm definitely not trusting this, this doppelganger dude. It's funny, because that's all I come up and I was like, what would Douglas actually do, not knowing that, you know? Probably would just stop. When then Catherine came into the club, tell you what, like, if we didn't have Catherine, then I'd have just let this doppelganger go.
Yeah.
My liquid In fact, I have been bleeding in front of. I have been bleeding in front
of her. Yeah. We'll see if she realizes it. Yes, Insomniac Zinc. They used a charm person, and it was revealed that the lady was not a lady. She was, in fact, a doppelganger.
Madonna has been doppled.
A doppelganger? Oh, is that... I misread it. He said doppelganger. He did. It looks like a donger, but it's not.
It's not. At first you think it is, and then you look again.
You get too close and you realize, oh, man, tricked again.
Just five of those retweets right now.
Yeah, just a couple, man. Hit those up. What are we on the follower number? I want to update that.
We're on 426. Devin, at this point. 42. Consider your serums retweeted. Well, thank you, Mr. Robert. I do. I will continue.
So, 6-7.
The trains just came back.
Yeah.
And there am I right?
That's the problem we all face.
There we go.
All right. So, you guys have been led to this side of the. Let me close the frost roll window. I don't need that anymore. You guys have been led to this side of the thing as you went down another hallway. There is a teleporter here. There's another teleporter pad, and the Gorek will say, "This one should be operational."
Password up the eerie.
You guys have the password, I think.
We have it.
Do you remember what it is?
Take Wingsor and let me view the winter sky. Wait. Take Wingsor and fly. Let me view the winter sky.
That's good reading.
Yeah, and as the, you are wandering to the wrong one.
Oops,
over here.
Come back.
He's over there saying it at the other one.
take two damage again. Thanks.
Yeah. No. As you guys stand on this pad, there's a flurry of snow again, and you are taken. You are transported, right over here, and I'm gonna put you guys in like all kind of as you're huddled in this little tiny space. You find yourself in, let me describe the area to you. A triangle of crossed steel wires runs between three wooden posts in this crescent-shaped room that smells strongly from the bird droppings scattered across the floor. At the southern wall, directly across from you, you can see, open windows look down from a dizzying height, admitting a brisk, cold wind through them. There are doors that exit this chamber, and one of them next to a large mirror to the west, and another standing next between a pair of wooden chests to the northeast. But as you arrive, you kind of see a whirling around to face you is a sort of a blue-skinned woman in leather armor with flowing white hair. She says, "Who are you? What are you doing in my area?"
"My name is Douglas Temp. My name is Douglas." He's just forsaken his name now. that's rude. Let's say, we're looking for you to activate the portal.
She does have a spear. It's not like out and pointed at you right now, but she says, "You don't work for Nazanna."
"No, we're trying to kill Nazanna and Radsec, Radsock, whatever."
She kind of looks at you, kind of cocks an eyebrow. She says, "I have no, let me clear that off." She says, "I have no love for Radisek, but, this is my home too."
"We're not gonna destroy your home, it's love. You're gonna tell us where we can get up to the teleporter, okay? I have literally no soul. I will do anything. I am not feel bad about it."
"I have no patience for being threatened."
Well, I have a brewing business back home that I am really peeved about not being able to attend to, so don't step in my way either.
That's right.
She kind of like her expression is very, very stubborn. She doesn't seem like she's gonna, like, she doesn't seem hostile to you, openly hostile, but she also doesn't seem like your attitude is kind of getting you anywhere with her. You could attempt to further intimidate her if you'd like, or you could attempt to
throw a spear at a bird.
Okay. Go ahead and roll me an attack.
Is it the crow? The crow from the floor.
I mean, it's airy. She's probably the keeper of it.
Yeah.
I
just watch him do this and sigh.
If I awkwardly miss of the first, I'm gonna throw the second one.
Go ahead and roll me an attack.
Oh, wow.
Another spear.
All right, so I'm not gonna make you roll damage against the crow, because if you hit it, you hit the, like, one of the birds that's perched nearby with your spear. As it, like, the spear slams into it, the bird kind of hits the wall and slides downwards. She is going to let out a... She's going to scream in rage. She says, "How dare you attack my pets?" And then as she does, she's going to kind of, like, raise her arm, and you see just all of the birds in the room are going to start flying around in a circle and are just going to swarm towards you. And you have incited her... And she is going to attack with her crows.
Run over the teleporter and just say, "Take weak sword, let me fly over the sky. Can we win the wall? Take us all.
Alright, well, that is, you're going to have to do that on your turn, because I need you guys to roll me some initiative.
Oh,
man, I didn't,
We have one way of, like, we didn't even try an Angulus woman. You just kills all of them.
Alright.
You just see a bird. All I hear is Jimbo from South Park.
Ed turn.
I need that gold too much, maybe. Sorry, buddy. Got this.
So he's paisley color. Is that like a mating ritual of the birds?
Yeah. In fact, she's blue, I'm blue. Yeah.
Wow, I rolled 2 nat ones on that. Let's just respect that for a minute.
Yeah. 2 spears, 1 bird.
Douglas, I need you to roll initiative. You rolled an 11.
Okay, I'm completely different from Carmen.
And she needs to roll some initiative as she has a...
Bird versus plane. Bird versus plane, wouldn't you be rallying for the birds?
And she is going to get a 20, and her bird swarm, which I have to get. Let me check. Swarm of ravens. There we go.
I was going for like 2 birds, 1 stone, but it came out more 2 girls, 1 cup than anything else, really.
Yeah. Okay. All right. Let me as I try to get this music going. Let me find a swarm.
Swarms.
Of birds. I don't have birds, but I do have bats. Is that good enough? Is bats good enough? I'll use, bats will have to be good enough for now. Let me find some bats there.
It's true, I haven't made to fall down, it's just true, actually.
Swarm of raisins is medium.
Douglas just jumps out of the tower.
I'm down.
Yeah, that's a good way to get this done. just jump.
Go back to the kids and be like, we left your mom in the tower with
your mom was dead. She is dead. I told her she might not come back. She didn't come back.
All right. So the swarm that is kind of surrounding you also has to roll initiative. So that's a dex check on them. That's going to be 10. So they're going to go at 10, and that means we are going to sort some initiative.
Hey.
And she is definitely going first. So she is going to draw her spear, and she is going to. Actually, give me 1 second. Oh, Okay, so you see, before she's, like, as she starts her turn, she's gonna pull a kind of a potion off her belt and drink it, and as she drinks it, you see her feet kind of leave the floor, as she starts hovering, and then when she does, she is going to start casting a spell. And she is going to, cast a spell at you. The spell is going to, as a strong sort of wall of wind is going to rise up, from the point, and she is going to make that wall of wind, she's gonna basically use the wall of wind to cut off basically the entire room, trapping you on the side of the wall with the birds, from her. As the wall is gonna be about 15 feet high and 1 foot thick of wind, of just gusting like cross breeze. As she does that, she's gonna say, "How dare you violate my sanctum?" Daelon, what do you want to do? You are gonna have to. I think you're gonna begin your turn in a swarm. Let me check that real quick.
I apologize, but I have no soul.
Okay, never mind. Old swarm rules, new swarm rules, they just attack.
Yep,
we'll
just go for it.
So Douglas, what do you want to do?
Douglas,
not you.
Okay.
I skipped Daelon, my bad.
Yeah.
I'm going to punch her as hard as I can. With two on there, with hex.
Okay.
So she's...
You still have one spear.
I'll just go with it. Charge at her with both fists.
You can't charge at her. There's a wall of wind. You could attempt to charge through the wall of wind, but...
Oh, God.
It's up to you.
How tall is said wall?
15 feet.
I'm gonna look over at Douglas and say,
"Toss me."
What?
Toss me!
Why? I thought nobody tosses a Daelon.
Okay.
I'll toss you if you want. I'll toss you.
Oh, wait, no, if I throw my spear, it's just going to win wall. Which is stupid.
True.
I'm going to... I'm just going to... braced, like, defensive.
Okay.
You can hold an action.
I'm gonna hold an action and just, I'll use a key point to take dodge. Oh, wait, no. I'm just gonna take a dodge action.
Gonna thank Dragon Queen One for a welcome to the Adventure Dragon Queen. You're a gentle queen and a scholar. Thank you for joining us.
I'll just take a dodge.
Okay, so you're dodging. You're just kind of...
You're weird, bro.
So you're just kind of ducking, like, trying to dodge the bats. Or the ravens, I'm sorry. Okay, Douglas, it is your turn. I'm gonna put you here, put you in this one there, and I'm gonna put you there, Douglas. Just so you actually occupy a real square.
Where else am I? Are you bringing
me to the... Oh, I haven't brought you there. My bad.
Yeah, well, there we are.
I was looking at it, I forgot you guys weren't.
So I can't break through this window.
You don't know. You haven't tried.
I'm gonna try.
Okay,
I'm gonna try and break through that. Move through.
Okay, so as you walk through, I need you to make me a strength check. Or a strength saving throw, I'm sorry.
Okay. So, strength save. It's just a D20, I don't know what this. 12.
Man, I don't know what... I'm gonna turn this off, because I don't know... I'm getting a real weird noise in my ear. It's like a... dee-doo. I don't know what it is. You try and push through it, but this wall is just, like... this wind is, like, gusting at, I don't know, like, 100 miles an hour. It's pushing you back.
Okay, I can't push through. I'm gonna use my action search to try and do it again.
Okay. Go for it. No, it's you're stuck where you are.
Alright,
I'm myself. Okay, cool. The Ravens are going to make their attack against Douglas. And they are just going to make a bite attack.
Call me.
8 is going to go against, not Douglas, Daelon.
8 to attack?
Yeah.
I won't.
Alright.
Not so negative armor class, unfortunately.
Yeah. So you just kind of try and you're just swatting them away and sort of dipping and ducking. As we move on to Catherine, she's gonna say, I think I may have something for this. And she is going to
Yeah.
Alright, so she is going to... Let me just check the... No, that's up to 2. She's gonna say... No, that to Daelon... well, actually, no, she'll attempt to... Right now, she'll just attempt to, I guess, blast the birds, because she can't Burning Hands them. So she's gonna Eldritch Blast on the birds, and it's gonna do... 1 damage. 2 damage, actually, but...
There we go. That's double that up there.
What's up?
Not just 1, 2 damage!
2 damage! Alright, yeah. So I gotta check what the birds do. I didn't mean to roll that, ignore that.
Because
that's... yeah. So they've taken 2. Okay, cool. As we move on to her, she is going to Nadia is going to attempt to push through the wind wall too. So she's going to make a strength saving throw, and you see her kind of force her way through. She just manages to kind of disappear into the wind wall, and as she steps to the other side, she's going to attempt to use a strength check to grapple this woman. And a strength
Nadia, the hot carry there.
Yeah.
Clutch for us. We'll just stand back and watch. I think she's got it.
We
start taking the bets.
Alright, so that's gonna be
against
a...
Forgot my turn to take bets.
Yeah. Where's her strength? I can't find it on this. Oh, there it is. Oh, yeah, no, that's gonna be against a negative one. And Nadia just manages to grab the flying woman's leg and just kind of haul her down to the ground, pinning her arm behind her back, so she has her grappled at this point.
Nice.
She says, be quick over there! I can't hold her for very long!
We're trying to kill her.
Alright, and as we, as...
We're so there for me.
So she skirted the wind wall?
She pushed through it.
Oh.
She just kind of used the wall to brace herself a little bit.
She's just stronger than us.
Right. This woman is going to attempt to break out of the grapple. Nah, she is stuck. She can't do anything. The only thing she basically is... She can't move, and she has a spear that she can't really jab with. So, Daelon, what do you want to do?
I want to, I want to follow in her footsteps and kind of crawl under the wind wall a little bit.
It's not really gonna help you, but you can. You need a strength check to push through.
Okay. I still wanna. For some reason, it makes sense to Daelon.
Yeah, that's fine. I mean, I was saying like you're not gonna get advantage or anything.
It's okay.
Strength check.
Strength check. -2. Let's go, guys.
We got this.
Let's go.
You
6.
You do not manage to push through the wind wall.
Nailed it.
And I'll just stand up after that and just kind of like mime around the wind wall.
Okay. You are still on this side of it. Okay, as we move on to Douglas.
Alright, we lost 3 of those dungeons in a row now. I'm gonna try and break through again. The old strength check.
Alright, go for it.
5. Get me now. Next turn.
The bats are going to, or the ravens are going to swarm. They're going to actually swarm around Douglas. They're going to make a make some attack against you. That's an 18.
Nope, that's good.
As you take 4 damage from their beaks.
Alright.
Down to 16. Alright. They get to her, Catherine is going to say, I can't attack them when you're in the swarm. And she is going to...
Okay, Catherine.
I'm
trying to break through. Like,
I'm trying to think what she might do.
She's probably a, like, single target stuff.
Yeah, unfortunately, swarms kind of have, you know, it's not great against them. Yeah, she has a lot of single target stuff. She does have burning hands, but that would catch you in it, Douglas.
Is it a constitution
thing? Burning hands is a I don't know what burning hands is. Let me cast it. First level is a dexterity save. So you wanna let her burn you? All right, she's gonna kind of conjure, and then she blasts the area with a cone of flame. I need you to make a dexterity save, as do the birds.
That's 5.
You do not make it. The birds do make it, for half damage. But swarms do take double damage from area attacks. So you are both going to take 15 damage. The swarm, however, is pretty much completely incinerated.
Just do it, okay? No.
the swarm is incinerated as we get rid of that. But Douglas is in a very bad shape. She says, oh, "I'm sorry," and she's gonna hold out her healing potion to you. Nadia is going, while she's here, she's going to attempt to, attempt to beat this woman into submission with her sword. So these are gonna be non-lethal attacks. Double crit!
God damn it!
I love how I rolled 2 ones before, and now I rolled 2 crits. So, Nadia is the MVP today, and she is going to double crit this because she has multi attack too. So she's gonna. That's 1, and that's 2. And she just smashes this woman in the head with the pommel of her sword. Boom, boom, and you hear sort of the audible crack against her skull as she is going to take, what is that, 10 and 9, so that's 19 damage. She hasn't taken any before, and she has how much? Not that much. Wow, okay. She has 1 HP left.
It's just stuck by this wall again.
We have, me and Daelon have
so burdening.
Literally done nothing.
Watch them. Oh lord, she's gonna roll
like 3 stooges.
She's gonna attempt to roll a strength check to get out, but very weakly. I'm gonna give her minus that because, yeah, she's just like, ah. You hear her kind of as she just kind of limply goes unconscious, and the concentration of her wind wall is going to drop.
I'm gonna use my action surge real quick.
Okay.
Sorry, my second wind real quick.
Yeah.
Just a bonus action. Just 1d10 plus 5 to heal up.
Alright, get some health.
Fuck my life.
You guys are great at rolling today. I don't even know.
I'm gonna take a healing potion.
Alright, so as the Nadia is gonna kind of push the woman onto the ground, she says, I believe this is the one Hatch said that we were supposed to make friends with.
Yeah, that's true. We were gonna be a friend, and then... Daelon attacked the bird, and she got really protective over it, so... I'm pretty sure she was bad.
Just kinda kick around the birds on the floor.
I start tying this girl up.
Okay.
like tired.
Right? Yeah, she is unconscious and she is out. You can, if you'd like to take some time to tie her up, you can do that.
Yeah, I was tired.
Okay, you restrain her.
Yeah, I'm gonna take her spear.
You take her spear. I will tell you what she has if you.
She has a magical focus, so I'll take that.
Okay. So she's already used that. You find in her belt next to where she pulled the potion out. She has a scroll, a magic scroll. She's wearing a leather armor, and she has a light wooden shield on her back, as well as a dagger. Daelon, she has a. It's not a full length spear. It's like a short spear. She does have a holy symbol, which is one that you've never, well, I guess you might be familiar with it. It is a symbol of Gozra. It is the god of sky and ocean. It's like a wooden symbol. It's carved in, like, the shape of a leaf with a drop, a drop of water coming off of it.
What is it?
It's a holy symbol of Gozra.
Okay. How is it, like, fastened?
It's on a necklace. Yeah, it's on an amulet. She also has a necklace under it. It appears to be a silver necklace with sort of a star-shaped ice diamond pendant.
I'll take the necklaces.
Okay. And also in her pocket next to the scroll, she has what appears to be a faintly glowing blue crystal.
That as well.
Yeah,
I just wakes up with no eyes.
I gotta wake her up.
Okay.
Excuse me. You awake?
You kind of after a little while, you kind of shake her awake, and she, and she kind of goes to sort of defend herself, but her hands are tied up.
You're getting grappled and then destroyed by Nadia.
Yeah.
Absolutely wrecked by Nadia.
Wow.
I'm gonna say, don't worry, we're not gonna hurt you. We just wanted to kill that bird.
She says, what do you need from me? I have nothing to give you.
Just like I told you before, we wanna... What do we want again, Daelon?
We want access. We need you to turn on the teleport.
That's so right.
Stop getting impaled by ice, and we need to go.
The key.
That dude,
the key. Radosek gave me the key. It's in my pocket.
Oh, this blue crystal thing.
Yes.
Okay, that's it.
That's all you need.
Okay, I'm just gonna walk away, leaving her like down.
Davis turns and walks. Okay.
As you kind of you make your way towards the teleporter with Catherine, Nadia will before she joins you, she'll kind of cut, like, use her knife and cut the rope. She says, "We're going to be making a mess of this place. If you have no love for it, you may want to clear out."
I like how we just came in and destroyed her livelihood. Like, oh, there's the area. That's
so,
bird.
Yeah.
No, her birds are gone. She's like, this is my home. And then...
So what do you guys want to do?
Teleport down.
Teleport down?
Do you have the password?
Sure. Let's do the, onward.
Onward, upward, in a tick. Don't be late, just be quick.
Nothing happens.
Gathering within the hall, take us one, take us all.
She, nothing happens.
And I roll downward to the ground, every ounce, every pound.
Nothing happens. As she's kind of picking herself off the ground, she says, Down a level to the halls, leave this cage without walls.
I just kind of drag her over, have her beside it.
You wanna actually force her to go with you?
No, I'll bet on myself.
Okay.
I say you stay here. Don't tell anyone that we're here, else I'll come back and skin you alive. Okay.
So you recite the phrase that she gives you, and you guys are brought this you guys are brought, this time without the doppelganger. He actually stays behind as you guys are brought to the level, and I'll set, you can make your way back into the room where the non-working transporter was. And I'm assuming you're going to do it, when you find there's a small hole in the wall that you can just sort of insert the crystal key in and turn it, and as you do, the teleporter glows blue and you are sent upwards to the next level.
Nice.
And as that is going to happen, let me just bring you guys to where it brings you. So as you arrive in this level, you see sort of a translucent image of a globe hanging suspended in midair, slowly rotating in place above a summoning circle in the blue tiled floor of this large chamber. Lines of arcane energy glow across the globe's surface, faintly humming with power as they connect to multiple endpoints in a radiant glow bright enough to illuminate the domed ceiling up ahead. Many tables and shelves covered in books, maps, and large scrolls line the room's circular walls, and the ornate mirror hangs between two open windows to the west, while twin ice sculptures of demonic fiends flank a bubbling cauldron in an archway leading into a deep alcove to the south. And in this place, of course, this is a good time for my PDF to crash. You see there is a man who is standing in this room, and I will, rather than, I'm actually just going to get an image to show you rather than a token. So give me 2 seconds to upload this.
Yeah, don't worry, I'll look after it. We've got this next game starting here, which is going to be Carnage at Canefield, which is going to be interesting. It's a good title for the game, certainly. It's one that definitely will bring ruin and destruction to my players. Carnage.
Carnage at Canefield.
Carnage at Canefield. We're coming to cinemas, Nathan.
Alright, so... You, as you step into this room, you see a man, and he is going to look just sort of at you, and as you see him sort of conjuring with this globe. I will show that to the players, show to everyone, and make it, that's what it looks like as he's standing there. There is a goat that is sitting next to him. Yes, there is. And as he turns to you, and kind of points this icicle that he's using to conjure magic along the sphere and points it, he says, you see the form, like this sort of icy vortex above his head that is the form of the woman that you saw in the mirror as she looks down, and he says,
"My lord told me you'd be coming. I have prepared my home for you. I hope you enjoy your brief stay, for I can not let you leave."
And as he sort of conjures, uses this icicle to kind of conjure a flurry of shards of ice and stuff around him, and kind of you see these sort of demon ice statues begin to animate around him, and as they rear up, and you guys,
thanks Cyber Scooge for falling. Welcome, Cyber Scooge, to the adventure. You're a gentleman and a scholar.
Yeah. And exactly what happens to Cyber Scooge, the demons, and this man, this crazy looking man, we're gonna have to wait till next week to find out, because that is where we will end things.
Oh boy. Well, guys in chat, what did you think of today's episode of the Reign of Winter? I certainly enjoyed it a lot. But remember, whilst we are finishing up this game here, we've got a new show and a new campaign starting just here in about 5 minutes' time, which can be called The Carnage at Canefield. So hang around for another 5 minutes. New players, new show, new campaign, new everything is about to start here in a few moments, so do not go anywhere. But yeah, I definitely really enjoyed today's session a lot. And thanks so much to Deadwalker1975 for following. Welcome, my friend. You are a gentleman and a scholar. How does he do it? So thanks again to Brian for Exploding Dice for hosting this show today. So Brian, what do you do on the internet? Let us know where we can find you.
Yeah, once again, thank you everyone for hanging out, everyone in chat. I hope you guys had a great time. Thank you, of course, Will and Transy for being awesome players, and all the donations that made today just kind of a wild session overall. My name is Askren. I'm the host and the dungeon master of the Exploding Dice channel on Twitch TV. You can find us at twitch.tv/explodingdice, where we play live D&D every Sunday. And also, I have an awesome talk show called Fuzzy Dice that airs every Tuesday at 8 p.m. on my channel, where I have different D&D-related guests, podcasters, Twitch streamers, and bloggers. This week, I'll be hanging out with Benjamin Loomis from Sirenscape and Dice Stormers. And also, I'm here DMing a lot. I'm always, you know, and on the 24-hour streams and stuff. So, thanks for hanging out, guys.
Nice. Trains, you do things on the internet. Do you not?
I am a full-time caster here on Twitch. I am working towards doing 3 cooking shows a week. We did one yesterday. I also play a lot of MechWarrior Online, and I do a variety hour starting at 8:30 p.m. East. In addition to being here every Thursday.